Hi, this video is a part of data visualization with Python playlist. In this video, I'll explain drawing of customized histogram plot using matplotlib. This notebook contains different types of visualization, but we are interested in customized histogram plot using matplotlib in this video. We'll load the Canada dataset where there is an information for different countries immigration from 1980 to 2013 to Canada. So the first step is to clean the dataset, where we will drop all the unnecessary columns and we'll rename the column odd name to the country. And then we will set the country column to be the index. And then we'll find out the total immigration for each of the country by summing this data frame along first axis. So this is the new shape of the data frame after this cleaning process. Once we have done that, we'll extract the data for Denmark, Norway and Sweden country. So this is how we have extracted out the data. But one more thing is that we do not want these countries to be the columns. Instead, we want these we don't want these years to be the columns. We want these years to be the rows. For that reason, we have transposed this data set. So the years became the rows and the countries became the columns. Then what we'll do is we will use this MPL, which is basically matplotlib. We have imported it as MPL, and then we are using the ggplot style for all the plotting. Now, what is this numpy.histogram function? I'll come back to that later. But before that, let me tell you this plot function of data frame that we are using. This plot function is internally using matplotlib functionality. However, it is a very, very great interface which can infer values from the data frame directly. And this is a kind of a high level interface that we are given by the pandas data frames. So we use this plot function, and the kind parameter is kind of a way of telling which kind of plot do we need. So here we are interested in histograms. Then we are interested in generating a plot having figure of a size 12, 4, and then we are interested in a histogram where values have been divided into 20 different bins. So for each of the country, all of the values will be divided into 20 different bins. And then the alpha function is actually a transparency where for three different countries, the histograms do not overlap. Instead, there is a kind of transparency. Then we have this xsticks. Xsticks is important. Why? Because if you're using 20 bins, it means we are dividing the whole data set into 20 bins. So we are having these 20 bars. Then xstick values will be generated for each of the bar. The problem is if we use all of these 20 values on the x-axis, then they will be cluttered together. And we do not want this cluttering because it will not look pretty. For that reason, what we need to do is we need to create our own histogram of this data frame and divide this data frame into only 8 bins. And those 8 bins will be stored in this bin edges, and the values and the count for each of the bin will be stored in this count variable. This bin edges will be used as xsticks. So instead of 20 xstick values, we will be using only 8 xstick values. So that is what we are doing. We are just trying to create our own bin xstick labels, xstick values, instead of using the default xstick values based on these 20 bins, just to beautify and prettify the histogram. Then we use our own colors for each of the country. For Denmark, we use coral, and then for Norway, we are using dark slate blue, and for Sweden, we are using medium sea green. Then finally, we are adding the title, y label and x label, and we are using this show function of plot. This PLT is basically matplotlib.pyplot. We have imported it as PLT, and this is how this histogram is generated.